The country's third telco player, Dito Telecommunity, sets the date for its highly anticipated commercial launch next month. As the competition heats up, consumers are also eager to see how existing telcos are going to respond to the newcomer's arrival. Warren De Guzman reports.
Jojo Armas works hard for his family as a driver for a ride-hailing service. In his line of work, a reliable internet connection is a must. That is why he is excited about the commercial launch of Dito Telecommunity in March.
Meron kasing lugar na dead spot. Minsan nawawala yung signal. Kaya minsan lilipat ako sa isang network. Kaya obligado akong dalawang ginagamit kong network. Depende sa signal kung maganda yung dating sa amin. Diba? Hindi. Yun ang kailangan kasi namin sa trabaho namin.
Tricycle driver Frederick Stevenson also welcomes the entry of a new telco firm. He hopes Dito will start a price war and force other telcos to cut prices and up their game.
Nagsalita si Presidente na ayusin niya ng December, bigla silang gumanda, yung pala may parating. Baka kinakabahan sila dun sa parating nakakompetisyon, kaya maganda yan kasi baka magagumanda ang servisyo.
Dito Telecommunity of Davao-based businessman Dennis Uri will launch on March 8, but it'll only start selling SIM cards and telco services in 17 cities and their surrounding municipalities in the Visayas and Mindanao. The rest of the country, including the National Capital Region, will follow in a phased launch, which should be completed before June.
Specifically in Davao, we will be, that's one of the very first areas where we will be having our launch, and also in Cebu. By the second quarter of this year, we will already be commercially available nationally.
Dito adds it is also on course to meet the requirements of its second-year technical audit of 51% coverage of the entire Philippine population and a minimum internet service speed of 55 megabits per second by July 8th. Dito Chief Technology Officer Rodolfo Santiago says right now they are already at 45% population coverage. As for service speed, he says they will focus on their 5G network to meet the minimum requirement of 55 Mbps. But there's a problem. 5G handsets are still expensive, with some 5G cell phones selling for $300 or 15,000 pesos or higher. Dito says 5G handsets will get cheaper and there are already more affordable units in the market. It is also working to bring in affordable 5G cell phones from China to give Dito customers a wide range of options.
May mga mura na. In fact, there are 5G handsets that are below 8,000 already. That will still go down.
We have had discussions on how we will leverage our connections with our Chinatel partners. They have such a big market, and obviously a lot of the handset makers are in China.
For Jojo and Frederick, they say they would love to experience the faster speeds promised by 5G. They just can't afford it yet because of the pandemic.
Abangan pa natin, sir. Wala pa pambili.
Warren De Guzman, ABS-CBN News.